The secret to getting better on camera. Hey, what is up, guys? This is Harrison Barron, the Millennial Entrepreneur. And like I just said, I want to give you guys the secret to getting better on camera, because after doing, 200 and something videos on YouTube, most people struggle with being on camera. Being somebody that has gone out and recorded other people before, people are very uncomfortable around cameras and they don't like being on camera, and they're very worried about the results that they're going to see or get from being on camera, right? Everybody knows that the camera could be the greatest thing in the world or the worst thing in the world. It catches you at the wrong angle, at the wrong frame. I can't tell you how many times I've paused myself videoing and I'm in one of these phases. Or something ridiculous like that. I'm sure plenty of you have just screenshotted that. But it's so true. It's a very strange thing, and it's very difficult for a lot of people to get comfortable with. I totally understand that. And I want to share with you guys my experiences on how I got really, really good in front of the camera. When I say really, really good, I mean, I would say over 90% of my videos are one-take wonders. I just go through, I do my research beforehand, and now I could just hit record and go through the entire video. And that took a very long time. Now, if you've watched some of my earlier videos, I talk about my first video after recording, and I was coming out, I was dripping in sweat. I was shaking. I couldn't believe it, right? And all I had done was record. I didn't even put it on YouTube. That was the craziest part. I had just recorded. I was like hyperventilating. I really was not well at that time, and all I did was hit record. I had some lights. I really didn't know what I was doing with the camera, but ultimately I hit record and just went for it, right? I was reading from a little script. In this case, I'm going to use this little piece of paper. I was reading from a script, and I had it right next to the camera where I would just, you know, you could see my eyes going back and forth to find the data that I needed. Well, fast forward 200 videos, and I don't need any of those things. Now, I do refer back to my computer quite a bit, and sometimes I have some cheat notes up there, but for the most part, I get it done in one shot, and my videos look great. But how did I get here, right? Camera discipline. That is the simple answer. And camera discipline, you're probably wondering, well, what is camera discipline? Camera discipline, for me, was not recording just one video. I would record video after video after video after video, and in the beginning, I would mess up a lot. My editing got very good because I had to take out a lot of ums, ahs, and this, that dead space, right? You're just sitting there. It's weird, right? Nobody wants to watch me just sit here, right? So I had to figure out how to get rid of all that kind of stuff, and I had to make sure that I had a stream of thought that I can get all the way through and put on my videos, right? Because I knew I needed to make content. I was really, really busy with customer work, and all of these things didn't really work in my favor, especially in the beginning. So what I had to do was develop camera discipline, and that came from a variety of different ways. Number one was I just sat in front of a camera all the time, even if I wasn't speaking into it. So on my desk, let me pull up my other camera here, as you guys are about to see. You guys will see, and I apologize, my room is a slight disaster here. You'll be able to see that I have, and it's a rather small image, but it already cut back. You can see that it's a pretty tiny camera that I was working on, which is cool. It's right here. This is my webcam, and ultimately I had my webcam just sit there all the time, and this image is rather awful. But the interesting part is I actually had this camera sitting here with me all of the time. And what I did was I got used to that camera looking at me 24 hours a day, or every hour that I was sitting in front of my desk, and it made, whoa, my life a lot easier. And I'm gonna fix this camera really quick. And ultimately, by having my nice camera, right, it's not an iPhone camera, which I think a lot of people are okay with seeing, right? They don't mind taking selfies. You would technically take a selfie like this, right? They don't mind being in front of the camera if it's their phone camera. Typically because they know a couple things. One, they can control it. Two, they know that it's probably gonna look like a decent shot. And honestly, you're just around it all the time. And this is where camera discipline comes into play. I would have my webcam typically set up looking at me all the time, right? And a webcam, you're like, you know what, it's on a laptop, I'm pretty comfortable with it. But once you have this monstrosity, is not the word I'm looking for, but this elaborate setup where I have a tripod leaning on my desk, I have a camera, I have a microphone on top of the camera, I have another microphone here, I have a light here and a light here, it becomes a lot, and it's very difficult to get over. So what I did was I would just sit here and I would just talk to the camera for, I don't know, maybe not hours, but I would definitely do it multiple times a day for 10 or 15 minutes. Some of those videos turned into YouTube videos. A lot of them were awful, and I would never release them, and they've been deleted, and they're no longer available. But I would just sit here, and I would sit there and talk and talk and talk to the camera, which would make life a lot easier for me. Over the course of doing this, over the course of weeks and months, I got much better on camera, to the point where it's almost freaky how good I am on camera. Now, I'm not trying to brag or anything, but literally somebody can say, hey, are you ready for this? And I say, yes, because I'm available and ready to talk on my toes. I understand that some of the questions I'm probably going to know, some of the questions I'm not going to know, but at least I know how to control myself on the camera, right? And this is totally normal. This took a long time to develop, right? It started out with a light. I would turn off all the lights in my old studio. I was a little nervous, and over time of sitting here and talking, right? Sometimes I would just sit here and I would read off text messages or read off Google results because I didn't quite know what I should talk about. All I knew is I needed to treat that little lens like it was a person. And once I did, and once I got over that mental roadblock of thinking that, hey, oh my God, this is going to go on Google, I'm going to be so afraid of it, it started to get much easier and easier and easier. And then I started making more and more content on YouTube. As you can tell, I'm in the process of doing 120 videos in 120 days. It's a lot of content, right? It's a lot of content. And by doing this over and over and over and over again, I got really, really good at being really comfortable in front of the camera. Now, I will give you fair warning. Before I started my 120 videos on YouTube, I was very comfortable on camera already. But that's because I already had 100 videos on YouTube, or 100 and I think 100 videos on YouTube. So I was already a veteran in front of the camera because I would just have my camera on me all the time. Then after a little while, I started to say, you know what, let me get myself out of the studio in a more uncontrolled environment, right? You see me next to the street, you see me in the woods now, you'll see me down at the beach on some of my older videos. And this mentality of getting out of my comfort zone and then getting out of my comfort zone again really made me and forged me into a better person on camera. So now I can come up here and just speak. But back in the day, I'd be so worried about other people. They're watching me. What are they doing? Why are they looking at me? Are they taking pictures of me? Now, I mean, somebody could be staring right at me and I really would not care, because it's just the process of building up my camera discipline. For many people, it's not easy, right? When I've worked with customers in the past, they're terrified, they're shaking, right? I've actually recorded a lot of my customer videos on here because they're much more comfortable on here than they are on a nice DSLR camera. After some time and they got used to the phone, then we'd bring them over to the camera and they would still be a little hesitant, but over time they would develop their camera discipline, right? And this is something I implore everybody to try out. Now, the best part about camera discipline, you never have to release those videos. Even if it's a skill that you want to have or use down the road, it's something worth doing now, because you're going to be better on camera, you're going to take better pictures, you're going to take better videos, you're going to make better eye contact, you're not going to be looking all over the place of what's going on, you're not going to get distracted, right? I mean, I've had literally people outside of my window doing landscaping work and I haven't even glanced over to look at them. That is the level of camera discipline that I've gotten, because I've done this hundreds of times now. I would even argue to say that it's probably been thousands of times. I just haven't released thousands of videos. I've just released hundreds of videos. But I don't just do videos on YouTube anymore. I do videos on my own personal website. I do videos all over the place. That is going to make me a significantly better speaker on camera. So now when I have to go and speak in front of a camera, I don't mind. Now, the weird part is it still hasn't crossed the border where I'm slightly uncomfortable still talking in front of an audience. But I would say the vast majority of other situations where I'm sitting in front of a camera, I'm very comfortable. Whereas back in the day, I would be trembling without it even hitting YouTube. So I highly recommend, if you're looking to get better on camera, you're looking to just perfect your skills, right? Start out with this little thing right here. This is probably the best starting point. As I blur out, this is a C920. It's just a webcam, right? It doesn't matter what webcam you get. You don't need to go spend $250 or $300 on a Logitech Brio. A $60 webcam is going to do the trick. If you're not comfortable with that, use your phone. Go get a little tripod, set up your phone, right? And you're just going to sit there and you're going to hit record and you're going to just speak to the camera. And over time, it's going to get easier and easier and easier the more and more you do it. Once you do that, then step it up to a bigger camera, right? Nobody's ever good on camera. I used to have, I don't know where it is currently, but a GoPro sitting around, and that was what I used to record, and I thought that was the greatest thing since sliced bread. It was different than the webcam, it was different than my phone, and it really made me kind of get out of the comfort zone before I got a really, really nice camera. And by following all of these steps, I gained camera discipline, and now I'm rather good on camera. Am I the best? Absolutely not. But from where I once was a couple years ago till now, I don't even think I'm the same person anymore. I'm so much more confident on camera. I can produce a flow of thoughts that come out of my mouth, and it just makes sense, right? Now I'm going to totally mess up, and I'm going to say or like, and things like this, or you should do stuff, right? And that's okay. We're human, right? And I'm doing this in one shot. I don't want to sit here and make 10 videos for, 10 minutes each to try to figure out which one's going to be the best, right? Once I get through the first 30 or 40 seconds, I know that it's probably going to be a good video. And these videos teach people information and value. And that's how I've been moderately successful on YouTube, because it's very hard to gain subscribers on YouTube. So this is the process that I go through. And now that I'm talking about YouTube, you should probably hit the like button, because I've put myself in a pretty a vulnerable place, right? And you've learned something. This is what I've used to get over my camera fright, my camera horrors. And it's something that you can do, right? Start small. Start with your phone, start with a webcam, and just go from there, right? Keep grinding, keep working on it. Heck, even social media is a great spot to start. Start recording yourself, right, over and over and over again. And the more you do that, the more comfortable you're going to get over time, and that's going to make you better on camera. So I hope this video helps. I hope you guys learned something from it. I hope you guys take away something from this. Other than that, I'll see you guys later. If you haven't already, I don't know why you haven't, but hit that like, hit that subscribe, little notification bell, and I'll see you guys later.